Energy metering for Powerwall 3 jobs is simple. On all Powerwall installations, two values must be monitored. Site, which is the total amount of power flowing in and out of the home. This will be equal to the values read by the utility meter. And the second is solar, which includes all solar at the home, whether connected to Powerwall, Tesla solar inverter, or a third-party system. Site and solar are monitored with energy meters inside of Gateway, Backup Switch, and Powerwall 3, and in some cases with a Tesla remote energy meter. The meters use a calculation to provide the real-time visualization seen here of power flow throughout the home's electrical system. Please note, Powerwall 3 is not compatible with third-party energy meters. Backup Switch, used on whole home backup installations, performs site metering with a built-in energy meter identified as meter Z. Gateway, on the other hand, can be used on both whole home and partial home backup installations and performs site metering with an integrated meter identified as meter Z for Gateway 3 or meter X for Gateway 2. When performing a whole home backup with Backup Switch or Gateway, all site metering is captured by this integrated meter. For partial home backup with Gateway, extra steps are required to capture the entire site reading. Any loads that are upstream of Gateway are not measured by the site meter and require the use of an auxiliary meter. Gateway 2 includes a built-in auxiliary meter identified as meter Y. Gateway 3 does not include an auxiliary meter and requires the use of a Tesla remote energy meter, shown here, installed in a backed-up subpanel. Note that the Tesla remote energy meter could just as easily be installed within Gateway or another backed-up panel. The Tesla remote energy meter can also be used with Gateway 2 to take advantage of this installation flexibility. In the example seen here, installers have more than one option for capturing the site reading. One option, as already shown, is to use a Tesla remote energy meter to monitor only the non-backed-up loads. Current transformers, or CTs for short, are used, one on each line. The sum of the measurements from the Tesla remote meter and the site meter is equal to the power flow seen by the utility meter. Another option is to use the Tesla remote energy meter to monitor the feeders to the main panel, without using the site meter integrated within Gateway, again, with one current transformer on each line. Both options provide the system with the site reading that is equal to the amount of power flowing in and out of the home. Solar metering is equally important to the functionality of Powerwall systems. Any solar connected to Powerwall is automatically monitored by the Tesla asset controller without any action required by the installer. On the other hand, any solar connected to an existing Tesla solar inverter or third-party inverter requires the use of an energy meter to monitor the inverter's AC output. A single CT is placed around one phase to monitor the AC output of the inverter. Installations with Gateway 2 can utilize meter Y to monitor solar. The Tesla remote energy meter can also be used to monitor existing solar. It is important to note that the Tesla remote energy meter is capable of monitoring both solar and site simultaneously. During commissioning, installers will configure meters and view real-time monitoring data for solar production, power imported or exported to the utility grid, and home loads. For more information about installing Powerwall and the Tesla remote energy meter, read the installation manual and the residential energy metering guide and watch the other videos in this series.